let's see how we can use the singular value decomposition to solve the linearly squares problem. And let's start with the case where A has linearly independent columns. Now, if A has linearly independent columns, then we know that its null space only has the zero vector in it. And if you think about it, what that means is that V right has no vectors in it. And therefore, this particular matrix right here is really all of the unitary matrix V. So, let's think about this in terms of the sizes of the various matrices. This is M by N. This is now N by N. What that means is that sigma must be N by N because the rank of the matrix is N. And what that means is that this right here needs to disappear. And this now is an M by M matrix, which means that this submatrix has N columns, and then UR is the rest of the columns, but that multiplies this submatrix, that's all zeros here, and therefore the reduced singular value decomposition is just given as such. Now, once you have that, you can turn to the linear least squares problem. And you can remember that if A has linearly independent columns, then we can instead solve the normal equations. And that actually we can then simply write as the solution that we want is equal to A Hermitian A quantity inverse times A Hermitian B. Now, what if we take the reduced singular value decomposition and just plug it in everywhere you see A here? What you get is UL sigma top left V Hermitian quantity Hermitian times UL sigma top left V Hermitian quantity inverse times UL sigma top left V Hermitian Hermitian times the vector B. Okay. What do we know happens when we take the product of matrices and we take the Hermitian transpose of that? Well, that's the same as reordering the matrix. Matrices from reversing the order and taking the Hermitian transpose of each part. Well, taking the Hermitian transpose of this just wipes that out. Taking the Hermitian transpose of a real value to diagonal matrix leaves it alone. And then we need to take the Hermitian transpose of that. Then we need to multiply that times UL sigma top left V Hermitian. We need to take the inverse of that, and then we need to do the same trick here, in which case we get V times sigma top left times U left Hermitian times B. All right, now, this right here is the identity, so it disappears. If we take the inverse of the product of matrices, we want to reverse the order of them, and then take the inverse of each part. So, let's reverse the order. We get V Hermitian sigma top left times sigma top left times V, and then we need to multiply that times V sigma top left U left Hermitian B. And what do we see now? However, we still need to take the inverse of each of these parts. The inverse of V Hermitian when V is unitary is just V. We can take the inverse of the diagonal matrices, and then we need to take the inverse of V, but that just means taking its Hermitian transpose. And now what we see is that this here is just the identity, and this here is just the identity. So, the solution to this problem can now be given by x hat is equal to V, the unitary matrix, times sigma, diagonal matrix, invert it. Well, it's easy to invert a diagonal matrix, times UL Hermitian transpose times B. So you would take your right-hand side, multiply it times the Hermitian transpose of UL, then multiply it by the inverse of the diagonal matrix, but that of course is just a matter of element-wise multiplying by the inverse of the corresponding diagonal elements. And then you end up with a vector, and you use that vector to take a linear combination of the columns of V, and that is your desired linearly square solution.